Hello, my name is Mark, and today we're going to go through the pre-trip inspection on a vacuum. So basically what we want to look for before we start each shift operating the vacuums. As we approach the vacuum, we want to look for puddles on the floor. You know, that would indicate any leaks of hydraulic fluid, fuel, diesel exhaust fluid, or even antifreeze. So the first thing we want to look at is going to be our wheel as we start here in the back corner of the machine. We want to make sure that the lug nuts are all tight, and if they're loose, you're going to notice maybe some missing paint or some streaking from rust. We also want to look at the fenders themselves. We want to make sure that nothing is rubbing on the tires and everything's in good shape and not bent. The next thing we want to look at is the cyclone or the manure trap. This is what keeps the manure from getting from the tank to the blower. We want to make sure that this is cleaned out after every shift or even between every load if the machine gets overfilled. This trap only holds so much manure, and it's very important that we empty it out, because if it becomes full, the manure can then get back through to the screen. Once we're sure that this trap is secure, we want to check our main suction screen. That is the last line of defense between getting manure out of the tank and into the blower. We check this screen to make sure it's good and clean, and also the housing to make sure that there's no manure in it. While we're down here, we also want to check, there's a sight glass in here, we want to check the oil level in the blower housing. When we're looking at the hydraulic pumps, we want to look for chafed hoses, any leaks, and also the condition of the wiring harnesses to make sure there's no broken wires or busted connectors. While we're in here, we also want to check the oil level in the Funk gearbox. This takes 7590 synthetic lube. After the hydraulics, we'll want to look at the engine. The engine compartment is an important place to check. First of all, we want to check the engine oil level. While we're in here, we're looking for engine oil leaks, coolant leaks, belt condition, and any electrical connections. We also want to make sure with the exhaust, there's no bird nests or any foreign material that can catch fire. When we're finished with the engine, latch the door securely to ensure that it doesn't come open during operation. We also want to look at the suction filters for the hydrostats and make sure we're not leaking, and also check the level of oil in the blower. Now on the Stage 5 machines, your coolant level is checked out here with a sight glass, as well as the hydraulic oil level is checked with a sight glass. We need to inspect the fuel tank and the DEF tank to make sure the caps are secure, the hoses and wires are in good condition. We also check this wheel, check for tire inflation, lug nut tension, and condition of the fenders. As we walk toward the front of the machine, we want to double check the top hatches to make sure that they're closed properly. Once we get to the business end of the machine, we want to look at the main hydraulic valve. We check for leaks and we check the hoses for cracks and breaks. We also want to check the cylinders and the mounting and the lift arms to make sure that they've been greased. We make sure that the springs are in place and adjusted properly. And we also inspect the condition of the rubber to make sure that it is firmly attached and will work throughout the day. As we come around here, look at your last wheel and tire. Make sure that the pressure is good and the lug nuts are tight. Before we enter the cab, We want to double check the condition of the steps. Make sure that they're in good shape and can support the weight of the operator. Before we enter, we look for any tools or any garbage left behind by previous operators that could cause a distraction during operation. We also will be sure to check behind the seat because there are wires back there that can get damaged with stuff being left back there. As you enter the machine, maintain 3 points of contact so you don't slip. Once we're in here, check your surroundings and also the park brake switch. Make sure that it's turned on. We sound the horn and start the machine. Once our machine's running, we're gonna turn on all the lights. Then we're gonna check our mirrors for adjustment, and then we're gonna get back out of the machine and ensure that all the lights are working. Once we're sure all the lights are working, we can check the function of the scraper head and the blower. I'm going to turn on the blower and listen for it to turn on. I'm also going to raise the head and check for operation of the wings and the lift. The next thing we're going to check is the operation of the seat switch. We turn off the parking brake and start the machine to creep either forward or reverse. We remove our weight from the seat, make sure the machine stops. After that, we hook our seat belt, adjust the steering wheel, and we're ready to go.